While braking, we generate a lot of heat as a result of the friction between the braking pads and our disc brake rotors. We want to have our whole braking system as cool as possible because lower temperature means better stopping power, so better performance of our brakes, and also longer lifetime of those braking pads and disc brake rotors. So let's see what kind of different systems, for example, Shimano uses in order to cool down our system, and what choices can we make. The rotors. First off, we're gonna have a choice between a lighter one and a heavier one. This one, made by KCNC, for example, is extremely light. As you can see, there is so little of a material here comparing to the basic one made by Shimano. So here we have less weight, but less longevity, easier to bend and easier to overheat. Here we have more weight, but better braking performance and also better temperature transfer. Now, this one would be the best choice for those for whom the weight of the bike is the one of the most important factors, like weight weenies, all those guys racing in uphill races. I would also say long MTB marathons, flat ones. This one will be more versatile, just heavier and more rigid. Yet another choice we have to make is between the one-piece disc brake rotor versus the one on the aluminum spider. We can notice the difference right away, but what does it mean for us in practice while braking? Well, in general, we can say that the one on the aluminum spider will be better in dissipating heat. That means lower temperature and thus more braking power, which is good. These rotors will be also stiffer and more difficult to bend during extreme braking, so that's also better. And these are also called the floating disc brake rotors. Even though the construction of this is different from those on the motorcycles, riveting of those rotors allow for some movement between the alloy and the steel, which will expand in a different way under high temperature. As you can see here on the spider and also on this box, Shimano uses here so-called ICE technologies. This is actually a system of different technologies that will cool down our brakes even better. In case of the rotor, that would mean not only the aluminum alloy spider, which will dissipate heat greatly, but also three layers of the rotor itself. Two outer layers are made of steel, that's for braking, and the inner one is made also out of aluminum alloy, so that layer will transfer the heat even better towards our spider, and so we'll have better stopping power. The ICE technology system can also be found on Shimano's braking pads. Here is the version with the ICE technologies, as you can see on the box, and here is the one without it. What's the difference? This is how the braking pad, the standard one, looks like, and here is the braking pad with the ICE technologies. Same braking pad, compatible with same brakes, but the ICE technologies means additional fins here, made out of aluminum, which will once more cool down our brakes even better. That means that less heat will go and be transferred to our braking oil, which is so important and crucial for us. And so, choosing the right disc brake rotors and the braking pads for our bikes, we want to balance the weight of our bike with stopping power and longevity of our whole braking system.